Good morning. This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Tuesday, May 15. For those of you tuning in now, you're joining us live inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 31 crew members. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the station flight control room today is Flight Director Judd Freeling, and next to him is Kathy Bolt, who is serving as CAPCOM, relaying all ground messages up to the crew. Topping today's news for the International Space Station, a successful launch of a Soyuz rocket that roared off the launch pad from the Baikonur Cosmodrome on a clear desert day in Kazakhstan. Last night at 10:01 p.m. Central Time, Soyuz TMA-04M, carrying its crew of three Russian cosmonauts Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin, and also U.S. NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, lifted off on time and as scheduled from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The three Soyuz crew members, having made it safely to orbit, are now on their way to the International Space Station after a two-day voyage to the orbiting complex. The trio is scheduled to dock to the Poisk module of the International Space Station tomorrow night at 11:39 p.m. Central Time. Viewers can watch the live coverage of the docking tomorrow night here on NASA television, beginning at 11 p.m. Central Time at midnight Eastern Time. Once docked, Padalka, Revin, and Acaba will join their crewmates aboard the orbiting complex. Station Commander Cosmonaut OLEG KONONENKO and Flight Engineers European Space Agency astronaut Andrei KUIPERS and NASA astronaut Don Pettit, who will be well in the middle of their 21st week in space. Commander KONONENKO, KUIPERS, and Pettit launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 30 crew in December of last year. They docked to the Rosviat module of the space station 2 days after their launch on December 23rd. Today, the trio will complete their 147th consecutive day, almost 5 months in space. Now with another Soyuz bound for the International Space Station, crew members aboard the orbiting complex remain busy to support ongoing research into the effects of microgravity on the human body, biology, physics, and materials, as well as perform regular maintenance and upkeep to the orbital home away from home. The space station with its crew aboard is now flying at an altitude of about 247 statute miles. The orbiting facility is making a northeastern track, having just come across just the south coast of Australia, between Australia and New Zealand. It is Soyuz, now on its two-day chase to catch up to the space station, is making a northeastern track across the North Pacific Ocean and is heading for a pass across the United States. The expedition crew began their morning with the first of two daily planning conferences a couple of hours after wake-up at 1 a.m. Central Time. These planning conferences are held with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Station Commander Oleg KONONENKO is busy conducting a streaming test using the US KU band prior to the arrival of the Soyuz, now en route to the station, while Flight Engineer Andrei KUIPERS is conducting an in-flight water processing for chemical and microbial analysis, while Don Pettit is busy with housekeeping maintenance, cleaning filters in the US segment and cleaning the air circulation equipment in the crew quarters. Earlier this morning, Commander KONONENKO worked with a couple of Russian experiments. He terminated the sonocard study and downloaded data from it to a laptop. Sonocard aims to improve the system that monitors crew health in real time. He also spent some time with the typology study that looks at the characteristics of crew members' activity, assess the actual mental state during long-term spaceflight. KONONENKO later spent some time to locate onboard treadmill hardware that is to be returned on SpaceX Dragon. This is the first commercial cargo spacecraft that is scheduled to launch at the end of this week on May 19 and arrive at the space station later this month. Flight Engineer Andrei KUIPERS logged his dietary intake for the day as part of an ongoing energy study that evaluates energy balance of a long-duration spaceflight crew member. He spent much of his day working to collect potable water supplies, or samples, conducting analysis using the total organic carbon analyzer to ensure the onboard potable water supply is safe for crew's consumption, as well as working with the environmental health system microbial capture devices experiment. KUIPERS also participated in a regular private medical conference and worked to transfer supplies and cargo from the European Space Agency docked automated transfer vehicle that arrived at the station on March 28. Flight engineer Don Pettit spent this morning working with the onboard medical ultrasound equipment to perform self-scans of his legs. This is part of an ongoing study known as SPRINT that looks at how exercise counteracts the negative effects of the microgravity on the human body. Pettit provided input to the ongoing journal study, then he worked to reconfigure the temperature and humidity control common cabin air assembly, also known as the station's air conditioner, in the lab. Again, you're getting a live view inside the International Space Station, where the Orbit 2 team continues to monitor the systems and the activities aboard the International Space Station. At the day's end, each crew member will have exercise to maintain his physical fitness and help mitigate the negative effects of microgravity on their bodies. The Expedition 31 crew members will do some evening prep work after or before their evening meal and pre-sleep period. They will also participate in their final daily planning conference with ground controllers around the world to plan for the arrival of the Soyuz that is now carrying three new crew members up to the International Space Station. The crew aboard ISS is scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.